Every 4 months, Ceasefire 365 organizers hold a weekend full of events and call for 72 hours of peace in Baltimore. Sunday afternoon, songs were part of an interdenominational prayer service, which included a reading of the names of people killed in Baltimore since the November ceasefire.
Somebody loved them, and that's what matters, and their life matters. And so we're there to honor the light that they still are, that still exists, and to give love to that light.
Two people have been killed since this ceasefire started on Friday. Baltimore police say a man died at a hospital after he was shot in the 1900 block of Dukeland Street Saturday night. A 27-year-old man died at a hospital Friday morning. He was shot in the 1800 block of Edmondson Avenue. Investigators have not named any suspects.
Baltimore ceasefire responds to murder. One way we do it is by showing up at every space where someone has been killed to put light and love in that space and to help clear away the darkness that's there.
Sunday evening, ceasefire organizers held a meeting with volunteers to explain why their practice of holding sacred spaces is important and teach them how it should be done.
You are purposely filling the space with love and light, and you can do that with prayers. We burn sage. You might want to bring a drum. You might have prayer beads, whatever you use to help heal.
Anyone with information about either of those deadly shootings should call Metro Crime Stoppers. The phone number is 1-866-7-LOCKUP. Live in the studio tonight, Vanessa Herring, WBAL-TV 11 News.